This project, we're interviewing a group of primary care clinicians from all over southern Michigan and talking to them about how they manage chronic illnesses, particularly diabetes and hypertension, in minority populations. And then in the second phase of the study, we're doing observations, clinical observations of those, a subgroup of those physicians, interviewing while they're doing consultations with their with patients that have these diseases, and then we're interviewing a group of the patients. And what we want to see is what the physician, they're mostly physicians, but there's also physician's assistants and nurse practitioners, but we want to see how they understand what they call health disparities, you know, that some groups of people in the population are more susceptible to chronic diseases than others, minority populations particularly, and that they're thought to have differential treatment response. So, you know, the sort of the science of it, well, what's the uptake of that in the clinic, and how does that affect clinical interaction? So, you know, that's kind of the impetus of the project. So they tell us stuff about how they understand this, and then by observing them in clinic, we can see how they enact that, and by talking to their patients, we can see, you know, how much of those ideas are sort of passed on to the patient, what's the uptake of that on their side. I love it on many levels. On, you know, in the immediate sense, it gives me a sense of satisfaction to, you know, have something concrete that I can be given to my students to use as a learning tool. You know, it's so much better than just, you know, saying, well, here's how you think about these things, or here's how you do this kind of methodology. You know, they're involved in it. You know, that's very satisfying. Although, as I told you before, it's difficult in a lot of ways. The act of going out and collecting data is, you know, it's kind of why you're in the business, you know. And when you get farther in your career, your opportunities to do that are more and more limited, you know. And I did make the decision to do this project here, sort of it's centered in Lansing in southern Michigan. And the reason I chose to do that was because, for one thing, I feel like southern Michigan is not as well researched as it should be. It's in really difficult straits as economically, but also it put me in a position where I could give this opportunity to the students. And I have the opportunity of, you know, it's kind of dividing my week between doing my sort of teaching tasks and then going out and, you know, okay, I'm going to go do another interview and go to this, and that's very satisfying, super interesting.